Hi friends, this is your Star Laboratory. Okay, today we are going to discuss about KA test. Firstly, we prepare the media and dispense into the test tubes. So after dispensing, we have to sterilize them by autoclaving. Then after finishing the autoclaving, we have to allow them to solidify in a slant position. So then only we can get the KA slants. Here we use the straightway to pick the colonies and introduce into the KA slants. So just I am sterilizing my straight wire. Okay, now let's see how we can introduce the colonies into the KA slants. So I am just picking the colonies from the chocolate agar with the straight wire. Then let's introduce into the KA slants. KA slants is having the button slant position. Firstly, we introduce the colonies by stepping into the bud position, then streaking onto the slant surface. After introducing the organisms, we have to incubate the tubes at 35 degrees Celsius for 24 hours. In this test, it is very important to get a clear knowledge about the KA pattern, so then only we can identify the correct organisms. We have to identify the KA patterns correctly. So we have to identify whether it is lactose fermenters or glucose fermenters, or whether they are producing gas, or whether they are producing H2S. So these things we have to identify correctly. Uninoculated KA media is in red color. So if the organism is showing the lactose fermenting, so the whole media can be converted into yellow color. But if it is glucose fermenters, only the bud position can be seen in yellow color and the slant position can be converted into pink color. So if the organism is having the ability to producing gas, we can observe the cracks, or we can observe the gas is there. But if it is if the organism is producing the H2S productions, we can observe the blood color changes. So that's all for today. After watching this video, please subscribe the channel and don't forget to press the bell button. Thank you.